Buzy With B. We busy being brilliant, breaking down your issues with B. The best of being busy, baby, that's the way it should be.
I tune into my station, baby, and get busy with B.
Oh, what we talk about, we can talk it out, ladies news, advertisement, what we bark about, charity, celebrity, what we talk about, therapy, prosperity, what we talk about, I'm from the nation cap, home of the Nets. We winning on you, Bama's, baby, best believe that. We losing all youth, the black on black violence with straps. Can't depend on politicians, gotta watch our own back. Put the guns down, youngins, life's about funnin'. Hate to see funerals, but love to give money. Shout out to VA and PG, you see us coming, MDDC. Be more what it do, dummy.
Getting busy with B, getting busy with me. I'm too busy being beautiful, loving and free. Getting busy with B, getting busy with me. I'm too busy being beautiful, loving and free. With B, getting busy with me. I'm too busy being beautiful, loving and free. Getting busy with B, getting busy with me. I'm too busy being beautiful, loving and free.
Getting busy with B, getting busy with B. She too busy being beautiful, it's busy to be. We busy being busy, baby, that's the way it should be.
I tune into my station, baby, and get busy with B.
Getting busy with B, getting busy with B. We busy being brilliant, breaking down your issues with B.
What is going on, guys? You know, I get super excited. It's like Monday is just a Busy With B holiday. But today specifically is Memorial Day weekend, guys. You guys can't see the whole studio, but I laid it out. But before I get into it, let me introduce my guest. I mean, I had to pivot. So I made a little pivot plan. But today's topic, we talking relationships. We gonna have fun. It's not gonna be so serious, but I just wanna know how we've been coping, you know, with the COVID-19 and how we've been adjusting. Yes. So we talking relationships today. We eating, chef. We got a chef in the building. I'm claiming it for her. Uh-huh. Yeah. So guys, we are gonna have so much fun. So introduce yourself.
Well, my name is Reggie Lee, and I am a singer, and I'm here with my forever man over there, Mr. Terrell the Artist.
Honey boo boo. So today's is all about love. You see the roses. I'm trying to set the mood, set the tone. I got the hoopas in the building.
Yeah.
I love both of them. You know, Danita, she does my hair. She gets me right each and every Monday. I mean, yes. So they're gonna be up here soon. You know, we had to make a little pivot plan. I got the Janae.
Yes.
I got Janae in the building, guys. She's feeding us. She's laid it out. We have dessert. I'm not sure what she cooked yet.
Smells good.
Yes, it smells so good. I'm gonna get her up here. We're gonna talk about her food, and she gonna let us know how to find and everything. But Terrell and Reggie, they going to.
I'm Terrell.
Terrell. Terrell, the artist.
I'm Terrell the artist. Yeah.
Terrell the artist.
And I'm Reggie.
Reggie Lee.
So let me tell y'all why I'm confused, first of all, because his page is covered all with his stuff. And so, yeah, so forgive me, guys, but guess what? When I tell you they are very, very talented, they're going to bring the music today. We setting the mood in here, okay? So because the show is packed filled, I'm going to go ahead and get the hoopers up here. We are going to sing Midway. I got James in the building. I apologize. I told y'all I packed the show, guys. He is the inventor of the card game, the couples card game. So we are going to have a little segment where we play the card game with the Hoopers. And I just got a lot of stuff. I'm going to try to pack it in this hour. We're going to eat. We're going to sing. We're going to have a good time. I got to get the Hoopers up here. So take a miniature break or not. We could just cut over that way and let the Hoopers come up here. Because guess what? I love the energy in the studio. Yeah. And you guys missed that at home. So I'm not even going to go to break. I'm going to let the Hoopers get up here. We kind of already aligned. And we're going to trade places. Hoopers.
Yes.
Whoop, whoop. Ooh, look at
these. I've been doing elbows, but I have to.
Y'all negative now, bro. Hey.
You look so cute in your busy with B.
Oh, well, you know, getting busy with B.
Hey.
Being busy, being beautiful, right?
Yes. Hi.
Hey.
What's up?
So guess what? I got my best friend rolling with me today, right? And she cracked on me so much. But her main focus and goal was to make sure I had my spreadsheet. Where is it? I don't have my spreadsheet. So once again,
I got your questions.
No, so this is not that part. but once again, guys, like even my last show, I do all this typing up, I prepare, and then I get right here in front of you guys, and then I don't have the paper. So, I'm free balling.
Okay. All right, that's fine.
We're going to have fun. So, when I say that, introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Danita Whitaker / Hooper, and this is...
Leonard Hooper.
So, guys, Leonard is a little shy. So, look, I went to get my hair done this morning, we practiced, and I tried to give him all of them positive vibes. So, we here, we got him, we going to support him, okay?
Yeah, we're going to do this.
Yes. So, this is a relationship show.
Yes, it is.
And so, this is not Danita's first time joining me in the studio. She's been joined me on at least three times. Yeah, at least three occasions.
A couple of times.
Uh-huh, yes. And I first met her talking about her son who passed away. But it's not going to be one of those moments. But yeah. I'm just saying how, you know, we got to bring that up. We got to talk about it again.
Yeah, so, basically, my son passed away 4 years due to child abuse awareness. He was murdered by his step-grandfather. You know, we've been dealing with it for 4 years, but at this time, we're in the stage where we're trying to refurbish, rebuild, renew, and transform, okay?
Hello? So, did I hear that? Yes!
Yeah. So, the process has been real.
Yes.
But we gotten through it. We got more to do for God.
Yes. And that's the fun part. Just watch. And so one of the reasons why I wanted to have them on the show as a couple.
Yeah.
Because I get to witness like this love and how they endure so much pain and now this power.
Yeah.
And so I get to enjoy this ride.
Yeah.
Along with a lot of people, you know.
You started from the beginning too, like right when it started.
You know what? And it's so fun to see both of us, you know, just blossom into these, you know, butterflies.
The transformation.
Yes. So it's exciting. So I wanted them on the show because I'm inspired by them, you know.
Thank
and
you.
So I wanted them
appreciate
to inspire
you.
My Busy With B audience. they're entrepreneurs. Mm-hmm. They doing their thing. And I know with the COVID-19, you know what I mean? Like the adjustment, like the divorce is up by 25%. And just like I said, I watch. I'm
that's
a fan.
Crazy. Yeah.
And so what I'm saying is how do you guys really truly endure? You know,
I'm not gonna lie, babe.
Time.
I wanted to divorce you a couple of times in quarantine. I was like, the court closed. Like,
right.
But no, like, it's so funny because, like, every Wednesday we start, like, just coming to each other. I don't know if you watch me on Instagram, but I journal a lot.
I watch you, Danita. Yes, I do.
I start journaling, meditating, and praying, and I kind of do that to my audience, too. So Wednesdays we start playing games, and then Fridays we start practicing on our YouTube shows because we really want to start a YouTube. I feel like our story is to tell everyone. It's just not a testimony that we gotta keep to ourselves. So what's some of the things that I did in quarantine? With you?
For the most part, hate on me playing the game.
Oh, yeah. She want all the attention.
Yeah, you know.
She want all all the attention.
No. Dang, babe, you put me on blast. I forgot about that. No, I have been hating. I'm not going to lie. I know I'm not the only woman that's going through this.
Nah, so it's
I'm
cool,
single.
Though.
I can't speak to that right now. But... I mean, like I said, it's a joy to watch. I get to watch you guys meditate. It's like spiritually. Mm-hmm. I've been going through a transformation spiritually. So
I felt like God came to me in this quarantine. Mm-hmm. Like, get yourself together. One of the things that my mom always told us to do is pray before we get out of bed and before we go to bed. Mm-hmm. But when my son died, like, I got lost in the transformation of praising and rejoicing, you know?
Right.
So, like, when he passed, I... started in the beginning, I was like, oh, I'm going to visit this church. I even visit Terrell Church. Like, I visit so many people's church. The lady that helped us with the funeral, just multiple people. And I just got lost in the process.
Mm-hmm.
So I think he came to me, like, get yourself together. And if you read the Bible, it say, like, you know, you could lead, and then your husband and everybody else around you will follow you. Don't worry about it, right?
Yeah.
So I'm like, okay, well, let me get focused. And I was like letting him play the game, and I was meditating, and I'm like, babe, you need to meditate with me. But one day, I could feel his energy.
Oh,
you know how you just feel it? And I was like, something wrong with him. Like, babe, you should meditate with me. He was like, okay.
And it definitely clears your mind.
And then when we did it, like, how did you feel?
I felt great, you know, and... put my thoughts together, you know. Mm-hmm. I felt really good, you know. I feel like I need to do it more.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I was kind of like, nah, that ain't gonna work, cause you know my thoughts just be wandering a lot.
Right.
So once I actually sat down and actually just let go and be free, that's when I really came to my senses.
Let go and be free.
Yeah.
That's the key, you know.
Definitely.
I mean, for the first time in my life, I'm not running, you know.
Right.
I'm not dropping the kids or picking the kids up, going to work, doing this. It's just, it gives me a chance to
be in
the present moment. And
right.
Just so, meditation, guys, if you haven't done it, just try it.
Yeah,
it's your way to connect.
Yes.
Connect to the universe, guys.
Yeah,
find yourself.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, yeah, for somebody who never meditated before, yes.
Yeah.
So, and what you, okay, so I'm gonna pivot a little bit more, because what you guys, Danita is a full-blown entrepreneur, guys. I mean, like I said, she does my hair. She gets me right. I mean, look, okay? Every week, like, I get to connect with this sister that does, you know, makes me feel, you know, match my insides. I know I'm beautiful on the inside, but just to be able to connect with her and go to therapy.
Therapy!
I call it therapy. Go to therapy every week and just, you know, talk about, you know, the last week or whatever we need to talk about. It just feels good. So I'm grateful for her.
Oh,
but I want her to just talk about some of her businesses and some of the things that they birthed in this corona.
All right.
Oh,
so as far as me, I'm going to start with me. I do hair. I came out with my own flat iron last year. I actually displayed it here in a couple of places.
Yes.
I also sell hair products, like the headbands for these frontals when we in the shower, some bonnets, lashes. I came out with my own watch this year. It's called Time Wait for No One. You hear me?
Hello.
So so if you do need any of these items, just go to www.dwroyalqueens.
It's actually, you should be able to have a picture of her
right there.
I'm on it, baby. I'm on it.
I love it.
Yes. So guys, we're gonna talk about Mr. Hoopa.
Yeah.
So guys, he also birthed a business
Absolutely.
In this COVID-19.
Yes.
And so let's talk about it. I sent a picture in of like the CMO. Okay.
You look so handsome.
I appreciate it.
Look at you, baby. But talk about your CMOs. Talk about your CMOs.
Yeah, I just came out with a brand. It's Temple of Power, my CMOs, not too long ago. You know, Ben's though, COVID-19 seems like it just took over society out of nowhere. I felt like it's good to boost up our immune system since we fighting an invisible battle that you can't see. So it's only your immune system can fight this battle. So I felt like it's good to get in the health business right now so that, you know, we won't be scared and we all can survive.
Mm-hmm. Hey, so Temple of Power, guys, I do want to try it.
Absolutely.
I really want to.
We got a gift for you.
No, y'all don't.
Yes, we do.
Oh, hold on. I love gifts. Oh, look, they wrapped it in stuff.
Yeah, right.
Ooh,
got a package for you.
See, this is my spiritual sister.
Okay, I put the sage in there because I sage every Friday once my clients are done coming to my house, and then Sundays because I just need to reconnect with God. So you could give her an enlightenment on the rest of the items that's in the bag.
Yeah, we got the face pass, temple power face pass.
I got
for
my
you.
Face pass.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You got your face pass because you forgot them earlier.
I did. Yeah. I ran out the house. I always run. I be too cute. I be like, I gotta go.
Thank you. I'm excited.
You got your CMOS, got the breathe power in there, so mm-hmm. you clear out your passageways, all that good stuff.
Okay, I'm excited, guys. So, also, one more thing I want to bring up on the Busy With B show. Thank you guys so much.
You're welcome.
No problem.
I'm going to put it to use. You guys, if you aren't following me on my YouTube channel, you need to do that because you'll get to see me doing things like this, you know, in my personal time and space. But I'm going to take this challenge, right? So I sent in these two pictures, and I didn't get to talk to my producer before I got here because I was running late.
Okay.
And so I don't know if he's going to pull it up, but, like, we connect sometimes. I sent in two pictures of Danita. She took a TLC one, she has like gray on, and it's her before picture.
Oh.
And then I sent in her after picture because I want him to pull the pictures up because I want.
Oh yeah.
I want the audience. Woo! Okay, guys. Jesus. So listen, I'm talking about this, and I didn't want to. You know, I love her. Like
I love it.
Look at you.
That's
now.
A transformation. Girl, what yes, you about? That's growth right there.
Hello. So listen. So here it is. So. Okay, that's the after. Who yep. want a fucking chat? Ooh, I can't do it. Okay, yes. But see, listen, because I'm motivated.
Okay, right.
Yeah,
right.
So excited. I saw this, okay, and then I text her. I said, you know what? I think I'm going to try this TLC thing, right? Mm-hmm. So I think I'm going to start. Well, I probably start. I'm going to start on Thursday, okay? I got to get the product. I got to get all of that stuff. And I don't know. We're going to work out the kinks. But
tonight.
I want to start as soon as possible, mm-hmm. but I'm going to take the challenge.
Okay.
You know, I'm going to become a member of her team.
Mm-hmm.
And guys, links going to be in my bio and all of that stuff. But first of all, I'm going to take the challenge. Look at that
transformation. Yeah.
I'm proud
he
of
said,
you, baby.
I didn't even notice you was fat, babe.
I ain't say it like that.
Leonard. Yeah. I was like, babe, I look so fat. He's like, I didn't even notice, babe.
So, guys, I'm going to take the challenge. I'm going to talk more about that in the upcoming shows. And okay. Danita's a friend to the show, guys, so she don't know this. But if I need somebody to fill in, I'm going to have to call on her. So, hey, chocolate sisters, we got to stick together. So, guys, I got a packed field studio.
Yeah.
I want to play a game with you guys.
Okay.
We're going to do a lot. I want to hear Terrell sing along with Reggie.
Me too.
That's what's up.
They were supposed to sing for my wedding, y'all. Oh, still.
Yeah, they are going to sing. You know, Corona has postponed a lot of things, but we still having a wedding. When I got my invitation in the mail, I was so excited. Guys, I've never been to like a wedding.
It was gonna go down too.
It's okay though.
It's okay. Cause
that means you wasn't meant to be there. You probably would one of those people. Look at this centerpiece. Oh my God. They need to come on our show. I need to get them some connections.
Oh, that is too funny. Guys, yeah, I did send your music in.
Okay.
PJ, what do I need to do? Do we need to get them set up with some mics? What we need to do. Oh, let me introduce the chef because the people in the studio, they might actually want to eat now. You want to come and squeeze up here real quick?
You want to?
Yeah. You scoot down. Don't leave me. Okay. You got to show that Busy would be. No, put her in the middle.
Put her in the middle?
Yeah.
Welcome.
Thank you.
You look so pretty.
Thank you.
Hi. So look at this beautiful layout, guys. She went above and beyond for the show. And not only that, guys, she swears she is not a chef, right?
I'm not a chef.
So even on the show, I didn't know how to introduce her. You know, I was like, hold on. So I just said up and coming chef. I claimed it for you.
Yes.
Okay, introduce yourself to the audience.
My name is Janae.
Talking to Mike.
Mm-hmm. My name is Janae. My Instagram is Janae Sloan. Bea, put it up.
I will. I'll put it up.
She's claiming me to be a chef, but I'm not a chef. I just like to cook.
When I tell you, it's beautiful, guys. She has laid out for us. Yeah, she's laid it out for us, guys. It's so beautiful. I cannot wait to taste it. We are about to taste it. Terrell and Reggie is about to sing. Then we're going to come back up. We're going to play a game. I mean, it's Memorial Day. It's fun. It's positive vibes. You are truly getting busy with B because it is busy today. Okay? So, again, I'm not going to break in the studio. So, if you're watching on WLVS Facebook, actually, I'm going to stop sharing now and I'm going to go ahead and tie into PJ is going to help me share the link on WLVS so you guys can see the whole studio. You guys will be able to see when we move the cameras around and it, you know. So be a little patient with me. PJ, can you turn on Getting Busy with B, getting me hype? Get us some microphones for Reggie. Yes. Get us some microphones. All right, y'all got them. Y'all ready? Y'all just, okay, I'm sorry.
All right,
let's go.
Testing, one, two, three. Testing.
Okay.
Two.
When they
going
to do that? They supposed to do it on the stage. I didn't know the food was
going to
be there. That's fine.
I didn't. He's telling me to pick a page.
I know.
Mic check, mic check.
Check one, two.
Could you turn this one up just a little bit?
Check one, two.
This one right here, this one.
Two.
Woo!
Me a little bit as well.
Testing. Okay.
Testing 1, 2. I think we cool.
Yeah, we're good. Yeah. Gotcha.
Mm-hmm. You don't know, babe, when you hold me and kiss me slowly, it's the sweetest thing. You're my water when I'm stuck in the desert. You're the Tylenol I take when my head hurts. You're the sunshine of my life. I just wanna see how beautiful you are. You know that I see it. I know you're a star. Where you go
know I'll follow, no matter how far. If life is a movie, oh, you're the best part. Oh, you're the best part. Oh, best part.
If you love me, won't you say something?
Hey.
If you love me, won't you? If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you? Love me, won't you? Love me, won't you say something?
Say something, baby.
If you love me, won't you?
Ooh, yeah.
If you love me, won't you say something? If you love me, won't you?
Thank y'all so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
We were in the North Carolina,
baby, best believe
that.
We losing all the youth, the
black
on black violence.
Oh my God!
Politicians gotta watch our own back. Put the guns down, youngins. Life's about fun and hate to see funerals, but love to get money. Shout out to VA and PG, you see us coming.
Oh my God, that was so beautiful. Yeah, that was my first time. So guys, that was my first time being a part of this spring. And trust me, I will never forget who's who again, okay? And so we can start eating, guys. If you guys have not seen this food that's in the studio, guys, I'm so grateful. I'm actually, look, I'm scared to get up because this is the unscripted show. So I want to get up and come. The good thing about being the host of the show is that, you know, my plate, you know, should be here. It doesn't have to be a lot now. But, guys, I don't know if I'm going to have time to even eat because we got more interviews with the Hoopers. We got to play a game that I got to do off the top of my head. We got to play two games. So let's get James up here. Come up here, James. Introduce yourself and bring the card game, too. So guys, this is James' second time in the studio with me.
Yeah, I came back in November.
Yeah, and I interviewed him the first time. Today, we are going to see how this game works. We're going to do like at least 5 minutes of the game. Maybe, you know, give or take a few. Mm-hmm. Okay, to see how the Hoopers respond to the game. Let's see how much they know each other.
They're going to be fine. I got faith in them. They're going to be
all right. Danita calls Mr. Hooper, Buddy. So I call him Buddy. I like Buddy. It's so friendly. Buddy. I like Buddy. So I don't see Buddy. He close? Okay. All right. So pull out the game. Tell the audience about the game. Danita and Buddy, you guys can come and sit right here. I'm going to actually move out the way so I can go eat this good food that's over here.
That's so good.
Right.
So we're going to play it while you're over there? You're going to do it?
No, they playing it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, got you. All right, so actually what we're going to do is I'm going to get in the middle of y'all.
Okay.
Y'all can't see each other's answers.
Oh, all right. Cool.
Got Got nervous?
Nope.
Sure? All right, now. Cool. So basically, the card game is something I made it to see. How well you know your significant other, right?
Okay.
And it talks about loyalty, trust, communication, sex, all those kind of different things that I think are the core pillars that make up a successful relationship.
Okay. Right.
So here you see they're color-coded, right? So we got the red cards that stand for the complete me cards. Okay. Like, how well do y'all know each other to be able to complete each other's sentences? You know, okay. The first thing I do in the morning when I wake up is, what's the first thing she do if she wake up in the morning?
Fix her hair.
Boom, so something like that. Yeah. So then we got the what if cards, which are basically scenarios. So if she was to get into some kind of accident, who's the first person she gonna call for help? Something like that.
Okay.
Then we have the scenario cards, which are also similar to the what if cards where there's scenarios, but I give you four different options.
Okay.
So you got four options to choose from. Then favorites is your favorite color, your way to relieve stress, X, Y, Z, those kind of things.
Okay.
So what makes this game different is it's a lot of intimate and funny questions. It's not just your regular, what's your favorite color? What do you do for your work? Like, we kind of get down to the nitty-gritty of things that you need to know about somebody if you want to prepare a future with them.
Okay.
So this is how it's going to go. One of y'all are going to roll the die first. I'm going to let the ladies go first, of course.
All right.
And whichever color she rolls, she's going to pick the card that corresponds with that.
Okay.
So what she's going to do is she's going to read the card aloud, and only she knows the answer to the question. So she's going to write the answer on the back of the score sheet,
okay.
And you have to guess what she wrote down. If you get it right, y'all get points equal to what's on the bottom of the card.
Okay.
If you get it wrong, then y'all got something to talk about.
Okay.
So, right.
So that's how the game.
Don't start now.
Yeah.
All
right. So what did I just vote?
So you got to choose. You got to choose any colors. You can choose any one of the four that you want.
Oh, I can choose?
Yep, okay. Choose any one. You want to pick favorites? All right. So read out loud, what is it? Favorite what?
My favorite show.
Okay, so what is her favorite TV show? Only she knows the answer.
Oh,
so she's gonna write it down on the back of the sheet of paper, and I got between y'all so you can't cheat.
I got it.
That's what people be doing
you.
The game nice. I be got to.
So I'm putting it in the color file.
Yeah, you go put the color where that is. And if he gets it right, then you're gonna put the points over there. So normally I give people like 10 seconds, but since this is your first time, kind of threw it in your face.
20 seconds?
Yeah.
Alright.
So what's her favorite? Is your favorite TV show?
TV show.
Alright, what's her favorite TV show?
The little person show.
No. <What? laughs>
Power.
Oh, Power?
Yeah.
That's a series, though. I thought you
were talking about
Yeah, it's still a TV show. It's still a TV show.
Oh. Buddy, that's a show.
That's right. Like a movie, though. It's a show, but it ain't like a
movie.
Buddy, that's a show.
So guess what?
That's a show, babe. You just now got us a point.
So,
nine.
Boom. So now you got 0 points. Go write that big fat zero
down.
You
know what show I was talking about, though? That
yeah,
you
the Lord, that was my show, though. That was my show until right. Power came out.
Oh, dang. Okay. See? So now we're going to switch it over to my man's. And he going to do the same thing. So he going to roll the die. Right at the bottom, yeah. You're gonna not pick up the card that goes with it. So you gotta choose any color again. So which one of these four colors you wanna choose? Whatever, boom, there we go. Go ahead and pick that up. So we read it out loud.
Okay. If I lost my job and had to cut back on expenses, what is something I could never give up?
So boom, so this is a real critical question because obviously we in Rona season. And a lot of people did suffer this. They lost their jobs. And now you had to reevaluate your spending situation. So what is something that you would not give up? Now then I want you to guess, what do you think he would not give up? Because now we're getting into priorities. What does he prioritize over, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So you're going to write it down. And she going to guess. And also the cool thing is this gives him time to reflect. Because he may not know.
Yeah,
like, what exactly do I value the most other thing? Yeah.
What will he give up?
Yeah, let's see. No, what's the one thing he refuses to give up? So a lot of
refuses that you work powerful. What's something that you work powerful?
So some dudes, they're not giving up their haircut. They like, look, we're on the season or not. I need to say, like.
Something. You're not cheating, Anita, are you? No, but I know he better put something important that you worked hard for.
What's something that you're not going to give up, bro? All
right, hold on. Let me change my answer.
All right, no.
All right, I'm ready.
What is he
you
not
home?
Giving
up? Yeah, she right.
What did you say? Yeah, his
house.
Home.
His house. His house. His home.
Right, he's not going to get that. He got to keep that up.
Yeah, got to.
Boom, scenario. That's my favorite. Boom, right. Here
the
we go.
Scenario?
Yep.
Oh, Jesus. If your significant other had to fight over another time of spending together, enough time to spend together, what would be the issue?
No, so I give you four options. So you gotta read out,
talk about a problem immediately. Forget about it. Whatever, bring it up. Forget about it and never bring it up. Older.
Oh, I need A, B, C, D.
Process your thoughts and submit to other views.
So basically, I'm asking, if y'all get into an argument, what is the way that you're going to reconcile those things? So based off those four options.
What would you do?
So we're going to read it to them again, A, B, C.
Talk about your problem immediately. Mm-hmm. Forget about it and never bring it up. Process your thoughts and submit. Go to other people for your views.
All right, so don't say anything. So right, what are you going to do? And then you write it down. We'll write the letter okay. down. And he has to
So A, B, or C,
yeah, A, B, C, or D. Yep. You want to? All right, so do you need to see it? So basically, she said, if y'all had a fight over lack of quality time, how is she going to go about handling the issue? Is she going to talk about the problem immediately? Is she going to forget up? That's what she going to do?
Hey.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was about you. Yes. Everything is about her or whoever reads the
right,
card.
Right. Yeah. Hey.
So you would talk about it immediately?
I would talk about it immediately.
Definitely.
But
yeah.
He wouldn't. Okay. Right.
So I'm going to ask y'all. So if y'all are in something really heated, you know, we make decisions, and mostly when we're in the heat of the moment, do one of y'all ever say, all right, let's relax real quick.
That's
let's
me.
Take a back seat.
And,
okay,
yeah,
so you're
going to I don't want to say something out of the...
Exactly.
Just
out of emotion.
I'm yeah.
Right,
so
exactly.
I chill out for a second.
I'm the complete opposite. I'm going on right then and there. But right. I need to
that's,
scale
that's
back.
That's
that don't work for everybody. That's what I've learned. That's what your communication style. They want
right.
to take things better that way.
Right.
You see what I'm saying?
Because I know I could be vicious when I'm mad, though. So
yeah,
I know
got
I gotta calm
you
down.
You can, babe. I haven't seen
oh,
it.
Oh, look. So look, now she's talking crazy.
Hey.
That's your name. He don't get vicious with me.
Go ahead and get another one. So that is green. That's a favorite, yep. So your favorite what?
Person to go to advice for. Hold up. Person to go to for advice.
Right, so who is his favorite person? So outside of you.
Mine.
No, his.
His?
So, yeah, so who is his favorite person to go to advice for? I'm sure he would say you, but let's take her out of the equation.
Okay.
Yeah, we're going to take her out of the equation. Who do you go to for advice?
Let me think real quick.
Everybody got that go-to person. When the missus is getting on your nerves, you don't want to talk to her. Like, look, let me.
I got you.
They over there munching. Look, I'm jealous of mother.
Jesus Christ, babe. That person ain't, that's the name. That look long.
Why you all over here?
Right, you cheating. Look, she cheating. See? That's what we got. Separate. All right, so who's he going to advise for outside of you?
Outside of me?
Who's in his circle?
Phil?
Dang.
For real?
Yeah.
Oh, y'all are so
I think she cheating. Yeah, exactly. I think she cheating.
No, because like I really thought about the last 4 years, like
yeah.
and who stood beside us and sat in our corner.
Yeah.
I would say Phil was the closest.
So oh, Phil the loyal
yeah.
one.
Yeah, that's my man's right hand.
You know your man.
Shout out to Phil.
So guys, that is definitely how you play the game.
Okay.
And so tell them where they can find you.
So you can grab the game at coupleofgame.com. You can also hit me on Instagram at coupleofcardgame. And you can grab the game. We also have a sex pack too. So I brought some of the sexual questions.
No, I
ain't get too crazy, but
I like that fun stuff.
Look, we got 36 sex questions.
This one for sale right here.
I like that fun stuff.
Yeah, so we got the original card game that comes with 120 cards, and we got 36 actual sex packs, sex questions.
Yes.
So we don't got to roll the dice. We can just pick one, right? So just, that's gonna be yours to ask her.
Oh, you should have just let me pick
and this
one.
Is, you want to pick one?
No,
and that's
gonna
be yours to ask her.
Oh,
I just picked a random one. So. All
right, go ahead. All
right, which one you want to be first?
That's the
How
fun stuff.
How many times a day would we like to have sex? Or would I like to have sex?
If stamina was no issue. So if you can go forever, how many times is good? So for you, anyway. So how many times would she like to have sex if stamina was no issue?
If stamina, okay.
If stamina was no issue, like I ain't never tired. How many times would she like to go?
She'll probably say all day. So
no,
I'll say about 4 or 5. Yeah, she'll throw out something crazy.
Nah, she ain't say that much.
I put 2, but I was thinking about stamina.
Yeah.
You said stamina was no issue, so 2 times?
It's no issue. If it was no issue all day, but like.
Oh my God.
Yeah. But if I could control the situation morning and night, like, you know?
Okay.
Oh, that's
wake
so cute.
Wake up before we go to bed? Got
yeah,
that.
Yeah. That's
what's your question, buddy?
You got the scenario, man.
Alright, scenario. If my significant other wanted to bring role playing in the bedroom, which would be my go-to scenario? Cops and robbers, A. B. Teacher and student, C. Boss and employee, D. None of the above. I don't like to role play.
Go right, D. Now put that in there because a lot of people are like legit freaks, even though that may not be super freaky to some, but a lot of people, they're not into anything other than regular missionary or whatever. So that's something good to talk about your partner. Like, you into this kind of stuff because that's what I need.
Right.
So, I like that. What's,
you remember him?
What's your answer? He wrote it in.
So that's
the boss and the employee.
His go-to scenario. Yours is C?
Nah, mine's is D.
So you're not into it?
You ain't into it. I was just a massage therapist the other day.
Now,
look.
We just not playing that the other day, babe. Nayo, yeah.
That was new, so I ain't remember that one.
Look, see?
Yeah, that was sound new right there.
More bro play.
We role played doing meditation. I was a massage therapist. I said, how you doing, Mr. Hooper? I came in to give you a massage. You got a wife.
That counts. That counts.
That do count.
Yeah.
Buddy, I need you to remember when your wife is trying to be somebody else. And the way she switch her hair up, I'm sure y'all.
Exactly. I had 3 weeks and one weekend.
You hear me?
Saturday, Saturday, and Sunday.
Hello. That's bro.
This is a dope game.
James, thank you so much for just giving me some time to play this game. I feel like you kind of interrupted my game that I was going to play with the Hoopers. But I'm excited. I'm about to play a game with the Hoopers. I'm going to see if they can match it. Again, I'm going off the dome, guys, because, you know, I don't have my paper, but I remember some stuff.
Hey,
but I I'm curious. Curious minds wants to know. So I'm excited.
That's what's
I cannot wait to eat. If they don't save me a salmon bun.
I'm telling y'all better save me.
I got you.
Okay.
Thank you,
James. No, I still want
some
more. Thank you, James, so much.
Can I sit this right here?
When I go, I cannot wait to go on my TLC situation so I can start wearing all these undergarments.
Come soon.
Hello. You got to be honest here. But, guys, I wanted to play a game with the Hoopers, right?
All right.
So, I'm going to ask y'all questions, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I want y'all to point to yourself. Like, if it matters, like, who was, okay?
Okay.
So, who was... this is not even a practice question. This is a real question.
Oh, come on. Let's just do the shoe thing.
Okay, do the shoe thing.
I got to take my shoe off?
Yeah, take your shoe
show
off.
Show them feet. I'm not looking. I ain't want to wear no shoe.
You got to keep the other one in your hand, so take your other shoe off. You got some pretty feet, boy. You can show those.
Look, that's my man. He got some pretty feet. So, I'm going to ask a question. The question is this, guys. Who was the first person to say, you need both shoes?
Okay, there we go.
Okay, there you go. So, who was the first person to say, I love you?
Okay. They don't be cheating.
No, don't be cheating.
I ain't got to look at it.
Yeah, let's turn.
Oh, yeah, turn around. Okay, yeah, both of y'all turn around. Okay. So, who's the freakiest? y'all help me with the questions. Anybody in the studio help me, because I'm going off the top of my dome. So if y'all can think of something.
Who's the most fashionable?
Who's the most fashionable? Okay, that's easy. That's an easy
who's
question.
Who's the cleanest? Who is?
Ask us some good questions.
I guess I'm getting
you want something.
You getting it? Yes.
Who's the biggest crybaby?
Who's the first person to apologize?
He tried to see. Y'all can watch the playback.
Who's the meanest?
Probably Danita. Okay. I like that.
You the meanest?
That mean is a balance.
I get called a mean every day, so I was thinking.
Oh, okay.
You would think you were mean.
Sometimes.
Who let Jay-Z out the most?
Who was the first one, like after a fight, who was the first one to try to make up?
That was kind of the same question.
We did. Okay.
But she said
I'm
after
sorry.
An argument.
Like after an argument. Yeah, that was kind of like. Because
I'm trying to go to sleep.
What else? Any more?
I have a few.
No, it's on. Come on, Ricky.
Oh, okay. Who's the most romantic?
Ooh, that's a good one. Who the most... Oh, y'all match. That's so cute.
Who's more likely to give money to a homeless person on the street?
Yeah, I like that.
Who's the nicest?
Oh, buddy.
I don't like to roll my window
down. No, me neither.
I'm sorry. But if I'm out, like if I'm physically out, I would give money. But if we at a drive, I'm not rolling my window down. I'm so serious. Like, no.
I like that. I understand.
But I'm the first to feed the homeless, okay?
Okay.
I'm a personal person.
Put your shoe up, baby. That's what's up.
Who's
like
the pettiest?
I love it. Like, you know, hold on. Do y'all know what I'm getting from this? Now, y'all did excellent with this game. Okay. But do y'all know what I'm getting from this game? I'm getting that you guys are balanced.
Balanced.
You guys are. I'm getting it right because it's like. They both patty. One gonna roll the window up for the homeless. One gonna leave it down. It's all good. It's gonna work itself out. But guys, turn back around the game mode.
Okay. That was fun. I wanted to keep going.
That was fun. I can't.
One more. One more question?
Yes.
One more question.
One
go
more
ahead.
Question for me.
Brian Finesse.
Are you ready?
Okay.
What's the last question, Ricky?
Okay. Stop. Okay. We're going to say, who's the most confident?
The most confident? Yeah. Buddy is shy. I know that much.
No. Oh, you really?
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't get that.
No, Buddy is really like laid back.
Is it
back.
Low key? Is it? Yeah, are you low key confident?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You confident though.
Yeah, he's okay. Confident. He's just low key.
He's low key confident.
He only confident around people he know. Now if he don't know he ain't gonna say much to you.
Okay.
Yeah.
No. So
unless be drunk.
Then he be friendly. I tires up then.
So guys, we are coming to the end of the show. We are coming to Ricky. Hey guys, we are coming to the end of the show. I'm super excited. Everyone joined me in the studio. I want you to talk about, you guys are trying to build your YouTube channel.
Yes.
You guys are working on different things. So tell people how to subscribe to your YouTube channel.
All right, so right now, our YouTube is under Mr. and Mrs. Hooper. We only have one video right now dedicated to our son, Dimitri Hooper. And you can follow me on Instagram at @ST_LadyDW. Thanks to Terrell, first lady.
Hey.
Terrell is my friend for what? 16? No, maybe 15 years.
Yeah.
15 years. I met him at 16, so 19.
I never lived.
14 years.
Uh-huh, yes. Yes, that's how I am.
And, but, baby, they can find you at
Buddy_love. 216.
Okay.
Instagram.
Guys, and so what I love, like I said, love about this couple, they are definitely trying to build what they have. Guys, make sure, as I'm ending the show, I'm reminded to tell you guys to get out and vote, guys. It's that time of the year.
Definitely.
Shout out to my man, Trayon White. Wardy. Woo, woo, woo. Go ahead, get out. I want to shout out the graduates, guys. I've been... Yes! 2020 graduates, guys. I mean, it's been a rough few months. I mean, coronavirus have affected each and every one of us one way or another.
Definitely.
So just shout out to those people that... I mean, look, guess what? You have a memory forever. I mean, I had some video. For some reason, it was hard for me to send the video. That's why I didn't get to show off your videos.
No,
and
it's
stuff.
Okay.
When I tell you guys, the Hoopers with their love and just how they've been spending time with each other, Rakia, quiet on set, please. What I'm saying is, guys, they really do just love each other. They turned their backyard into just... I don't have pictures because you sent me the video.
It's okay. We turned it into a spa.
Yeah, it was just so beautiful. I do want to come over and get in this spa, y'all.
Anytime,
okay?
Anytime.
It is so... It's just beautiful how they find time and find ways to connect and reconnect and just fall in love all over again. And today, I wanted to just spread the love. And I wanted to, you know, share the studio. So
yeah.
That, I mean, appreciate. Like I said, divorce is up. Everything is up. But how, you know, we making it through the coronavirus.
I just want to say, anybody that's in a relationship,
find out if you want to be with that person right now and get them out of your life, if not, because energy is important. Your time is important.
Yes.
Yeah, so.
Yeah.
Definitely.
So, guys, I have a lot of great things. You heard Terrell and you heard Reggie on the show. I mean, the song was beautiful. And what you guys don't know about that song was so significant to me. Because when I was pregnant, it was a song that I always dedicated to my baby daughter. Aww. And I just wanted to see her, and I made a little collage. I'm gonna share it on the next show because you guys are coming when you come. But I made a collage. I was all, you know, and she is as beautiful as the I song. Could imagine. Yeah. So, I love that song. You guys are coming back. We're gonna talk about relationships again. So we're gonna measure it out. We're gonna talk about relationships and just how Corona has directly affected you guys. And we're gonna talk about it. We're going to talk about it, but we're not going to live in it, you know? Mm-hmm. So I'm all about getting us educated. If you pay attention to any of my social medias, I'm always posting things to keep us informed, to keep us talking. But guys, I'm just in love with just being able to come to the studio and share my space and you guys giving me your time. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, my gosh. So, guys, each and every Monday, right here on Listen Vision Live, you can find your girl, Buzy With B. Go follow us on YouTube. All of us, right? Look, I'm going to put the links up. You got to follow us on YouTube so you can see behind the scenes stuff, that good stuff. Peace. Thank you. Yes.
I tune into my station, baby, and get Buzy With B.
Getting Buzy With B, getting Buzy With B. We busy being brilliant, breaking down your issues with B. The best of being Buzy, baby, that's the way it should be.
I tune into my station, baby, and get Buzy With B.
What we talk about, we can talk it out. Ladies news, advertisement, what we bark about. Charity, celebrity, what we talk about. Therapy, prosperity, what we talk about. I'm from the nation cap, home of the Nets. We winning on you, Bama's baby, best believe that's the being. Buzy, baby, that's the way it should be.
I tune into my station, baby, and get Buzy With B.
What we talk about, we can talk it out. Ladies news, advertisement, what we bark about. Charity, celebrity, what we talk about. Therapy, prosperity, what we